The Bible tells you that there are different times and there are different seasons. Even in the natural, we know that we have four different seasons. We have the winter, we have summer, we have autumn, and we have spring. And during these different seasons of nature, there are certain things that has to be done in a particular season. If we are in summer that we are currently in, it is not wise, it don't make sense that during summer you put on a long coat and you put on boots and you tie up the boots and you just fling a scarf around your neck. With even the heat stroke that we had the other day, you, it would not make sense, amen? So you realize that for different times and for different seasons, you know how to dress, you know what to plant. The farmers are very familiar with different seasons. There are certain things that you don't plant in the winter. There are certain things you don't plant in summer. I remember when I was living with my father, he would tell me that the best time to plant coffee would be in a time, the time of summer. So in the time of winter, when winter is coming up, is the best time to plant coffee, because for whatever agricultural reason, it is time for it to bear fruit. It will bear bountifully and beautifully. So even in the natural, we realize that we as believers and even sinners, we know that there are different times and there are different seasons for stuff. In the winter, you don't wear tough clothes that you normally wear in the summer. If you live where I usually live in St. Thomas, you would not find yourself having on a bikini during the summer. Amen? It was cold to the point where I used to live. It was cold to the point where you would have seen like snow frost coming from Blue, because we are close to Blue Mountain. So there are different times and there are different seasons in the earth realm, and so it is in the spirit. There are different times that are set up, that God has set up for his people to possess particular things. As the Bible says, there is a time to kill, there is a time to plant. So there is a time to, and there is a time to reap. One thing I understand about sowing and reaping, you don't sow something and expect to reap it the next morning. Can I talk to somebody? There has to be a season, don't touch it yet. There has to be a particular time and a particular season where you will go back to that which you have already planted. Amen? You don't take something, you don't sow something and expect that by next week you're going to get a result. And this is what sometimes we don't understand, because the same principles that applies in the physical, it applies in the natural. Sometimes we as believers, we do a Messiah, we do a particular thing for God, and we expect that by tomorrow God is going to do something for us. Can I talk to somebody? We do a particular thing for God and say, God, I did this, I saw this, I am expecting this by next week, or I'm expecting this by tomorrow. There are specific times and there are specific seasons that God has set up spiritually so that you can know which time and which season, when it is the right time to sow, when it is the time of reaping, when it's the time of breakthrough, when it is the time of deliverance, when it is the time that I'll be going through my valley, when it is the time for war, when I'm in war. And this is what believers need to be sensitized to. We need to understand the seasons in the spirit. We need to understand what is it that I am going through in this season. What is God saying concerning my life in this season? Am I in war? Am I supposed to be fighting? Because sometimes we are fighting and we should be in peace. Sometimes, Sister Webber, we are fighting. hurt off this arm of war or the Mount of Calendar, where demonic agents, I'm just going to talk for a little while, where demonic agents, they set up particular things in a particular time. You realize that in the month of April, going on to May, you have the witches and warlocks, they counteract, they seek to counteract, pass over, and they set up a lot of altars and do a lot of things within this time period. You have the period of going back to school, when kids are going back to school, in this section, in this time period, where they release curses and exes and vexes over the children before they even enter school. You have the time period of Halloween, where you have the day of the dead, where they do all sorts of sacrifices to counteract what God is doing. You have the time of December, where they seek to counteract the birth of Jesus, and they do all manner of evil, Allah God Almighty, and trying to prepare what would happen in the next, in the month of January. So it is important that we as believers, we understand your season. You understand what season are you in. Am I supposed to be fighting? Am I supposed to be, my God Almighty, am I supposed to be sowing? Am I in a season of reaping? Am I in a season where I am supposed to be gathering my harvest? What season am I in? And we should be, my God Almighty, we should be provoked to ask God, what season am I in? Because when you understand your season, you understand how to dress. Somebody missed out. When you understand your season, you know how to clothe yourself. You know how to attire yourself. When the sun is hot, we ain't going outside in a little jacket, because that don't make sense. When you understand what season you're in, you can understand what hell is doing in your life. Because what the enemy seeks to do, the enemy seeks for you to miss your season. The enemy seeks for you to miss what God is doing in your life in a particular time. I want somebody to say, God, what is my season? What are you doing in my life in this season? What is your Kodamashanda? What is coming my way? Why hell is fighting me in this season? What is it that you have set up for me? Why hell is trying to take over my mind? What is it that you want to do in my life in this season that hell want me to walk out of my season? Hell want me to miss what you have in store. Say God. Say God. Say God. What is my season? The Bible declared that in the book of Esther, the king had called Vashti and said, listen, he had a banquet and the king was merry and he was happy. And he said, my wife, you're good enough. I want everybody to come and see how beautiful she is. I can't sing for her. And the Bible declared that Vashti, Vashti decided to listen, when I come away, the king, all right. And they made a declaration that, listen, just in case the other women of the province decide that they want to do the same thing and defy their husband, we are going to take Vashti from her position and we're going to seek for another person to be queen. The Bible said that he sent declaration, this is the king, sent declaration and sent for all the young virgins. And when they came, there was a process of a 12-month process. First, now they were dipped in olive oil, and they were processed and they were purified. And then after the process of olive oil, there was the process of frankincense and myrrh and perfume and spices. So after God, the woman processed for 11 months, Vashti now became, Esther now became king, became queen. And when Esther now was queen, Haman made a declaration and said, listen, I want everybody to bow down and worship me. And the Bible declared that Mordecai, which was a Jew, decided that, listen, I only serve the And when Joseph was so troubled in the pit, I can imagine Joseph as a listener, this dream not gonna come to pass, can come to somebody. But God promised me, how is this possible? And I am broken. Oh, la la la, I'm broken at the Ten Commandments. Can I talk to somebody?
Can I talk to you about your life?
But I hear it. Fear coming by hearing. Fear coming by hearing. And by hearing the word of God, we walk by faith and not by sight. Because if we follow sight, they will say, God, I'm not yet. If we follow sight, I'm going to say, ain't nothing happening. Ain't no bringing. Ain't no going. Not buying no food in the house. Can I talk to somebody? To be not God. set you on your way. Your praise will set you free. There is an opportunity time for your deliverance. There is an opportunity time for your breakthrough. There is a time where God is getting ready to take you out of captivity. God is getting ready to take you out of the bondages of hell. God is getting ready to deliver you. But you must see what God is saying. Esther heard the word. Mordecai said, listen, if deliverance is not coming from you, it's going to come from somebody else. And you will be destroyed. And who then, if you did not come to the kingdom for such a time as this? She heard the word and decided to listen, we better go on a fast. Make a cup on a fast and then I'm going to go before the king. Say, neighbor, you must believe God's word. Despite of all you feel, you must believe God's word, because what the enemy wants to know, if you don't believe God's word, you're going to believe the lies of the enemy.
Check out.
God. You're not even kill up yourself, no, because you understand, say, devil, I am in a season of abundance, and I see you, I smell you.
It's just the truth.